صالحا ومجددا فرنوا بنذر طاهر وجنان.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today I will be sharing one of the strongest proofs for the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, which is mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari. It was often quoted by the promised Messiah, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alayhi salam of Qadian. The proof is the story of the Miraj, which was a spiritual journey of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he saw Hazrat Isa alayhi salam in the company of the other prophets who had passed away. In this journey, the Prophet ﷺ shared every little detail he saw, as this was the knowledge of the unseen, and the Quran says that the Prophets of Allah do not hide such knowledge they are given by Allah the Almighty. However, the Prophet ﷺ did not mention anything regarding Hazrat Isa ﷺ being there with his physical earthly body. He did not mention any difference between Hazrat Isa ﷺ and the other prophets, which proves that Hazrat Isa ﷺ had died just like all the other prophets. Let us hear the most famous Pakistani Salafi scholar accept that the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ did not see the other prophets with their earthly bodies.
نیز یہ کہتے ہیں کہ معراج کے موقع پر نبی کریم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے میاں کو دیکھا تھا تو وہ زندہ تھے. بھائی وہ تو معجزہ ہے, اس میں یہ کوئی نہیں لکھا ہو کہ وہ دنیا کی طرح زندہ تھے. وہ تو برزخی معاملہ ہے, ممکن ہے روحوں کو دیکھو اور وہ اب بھی قبروں میں زندہ ہیں. بالکل ہم مانتے ہیں کہ زندہ ہیں, لیکن برزخی زندگی ہے, دنیاوی زندگی نہیں ہے. صحیح مسئلہ یہ ہے کہ رسول اللہ قبر میں اور انبیاء برزخی طور پر زندہ ہیں, برزخی. اور یہ بات حافظ ابن حجر نے بھی لکھی ہے اور یہ حافظ زابی نے بھی یہی بات فرمائی ہے.
The greatest scholars of the non-Ahmadi Muslims have also said the same. Hazrat Ibn Qayyim writes that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ascended to the heavens without death, and apart from him, no one went to the heavens except after death. He then says, the souls of the prophets are in the heavens after they have separated from their earthly bodies. Then Hazrat Ibn Hazm, another famous scholar accepted by the Muslims worldwide who believed in the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, mentions the Miraj and then says, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, Hazrat Idris alayhi salam, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, and Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam were all present during this journey. He then says, this was the area of their souls, and the souls of the prophets are in heaven. There is no mention of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam's physical body being in the heavens. Then their other famous commentator Ibn Kathir has also said that it was the souls of the prophets. It is quite possible that some Barelvis and Diobandis tried to deny this. However, their own book Kashful Mahjub, which is one of their most published book, states, on the night of the ascension when the apostles sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw in heaven Adam, Joseph, Moses, Aaron, Jesus and Abraham, it was their spirits that he saw. These references make it explicitly clear that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam did not physically ascend into the heavens. He has died and will never return. In his book Barahin-e Ahmadiyya Part 5, Hazrat Ahmad alayhi salam states, all the verses that I have quoted here are sufficient to prove the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, and the same is also substantiated by the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The only difference being that while God testifies to the death of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam with his word, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does so through his eyewitness testimony. Thus God with his word and the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with his action, by his eyewitness account, have put a seal on the fact that Hazrat Isa alayhi salam has died. For the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam testifies by his eyewitness account that on the night of the Miraj, he saw Hazrat Isa al-Islam in heaven among the previous prophets who had passed away from this world and had reached the next world. Not only that, but he saw the same kind of body for Hazrat Isa al-Islam as those for other prophets. May peace be upon them all. Moreover, I have already explained that it is an error to think that it is only the souls of the earlier prophets, may peace be upon them, who have passed away from this world that are present in heaven. Rather, they have with them luminous and glorious bodies with which they were raised from this world after their death. And the verse وَدْخُلِي جَنَّتِي represents a clear statement with regard to it. This is because a body is required to enter paradise, and the Holy Quran time and again says clearly that people who will enter paradise shall have their bodies with them. No soul shall enter paradise by itself. Then in the same book, the promised Messiah ﷺ writes, a body is necessary for entering paradise, but it is not necessary that the body be elemental. In fact, a body that is not elemental is required, because the fruits, etc. of paradise are also not elemental, but rather are a new creation. So the body will also be a new creation that will be different from the earlier body. It is, however, essential that the believers are given bodies after death. It is not only the phrase of paradise that points to this, but also to the fact that on the night of the Miraj, the Prophet ﷺ did not merely see the souls of the prophets, rather he saw the bodies of all of them. And the body of Hazrat Isa ﷺ was not a different kind from them. If you have not yet subscribed, make sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you can get notifications for every new video. Also, make sure to like and comment on the video and follow on Twitter and Instagram. Safina, salli ala Muhammadin.